Hello guys, thank you very much for joining in. We're going to be starting out with a very, very important chapter, or basically a concept that can be tested in your FRM exam. That is option pricing factor. And this concept is from your chapter of properties of option. Okay. And I'm Ganesh Nayak. I help finance professionals to clear CFA and FRM related exam. And I also guide them for their career. Now today the agenda is that I'll give you a snapshot of the entire concept, so that if this kind of question comes into your exam, you'd be able to clear that concept in a first go. Okay, so let us talk about the today's agenda. What all things we are going to be covering. I'll give you a brief introduction about call and put option. So when you're reading for this chapter or this content, it is ideally expected that you would know the basics of call and put. Okay, then we're going to be looking at what are the factors that are actually going to impact the option price. That is what the theme of this session is. Then we're going to be deep diving into individual factors, like the first two factors, asset price and strike price. Then we're going to be moving towards volatility and risk-free rate. And then finally, maturity and dividend. We'll also be looking at the summary of the entire, all of them. And then we'll be looking at the questions, few questions to help you solidify the concept. And finally, I'll be waiting for a few queries which might be there during the session. Okay. One more small thing, in case during the session, between the session, if you guys are having any specific query, you can post it on the chat. I'll try to address it during the session, or else I'll wait at the end. Okay. And also, when I'm teaching the concept, I would need your assistance, your feedback in answering, because I'll be questioning a lot of things in between. Okay, so let us start with the session. I'll give you a brief introduction about call option. So call option is basically an option available where you get the right, okay, where you get the right to purchase something at a strike price. That means at a fixed price. Okay, now this option gives you a right, but it is not an obligation. Okay, let me give you a very simple example. Suppose you already saw an option, a call option on ITC stock, okay, that was available in the market where the strike price was 150. Now, if you purchase this option, you are getting that right. Obviously, in order to get this right, you're going to make some payment. That is the option premium, that is the call premium, okay. Now, once you have got this right, if the stock price of ITC goes above 150, that means you have a right to purchase the stock at 150, even though the price might be 200, 300. Okay, so ideally, if you have purchased the option, call option, you would expect, you would be in profit when the underlying asset increases, and you would be in loss when the underlying asset goes down. Why loss? Because if the price of the ITC stock is, say, at 100, and you have the right to purchase at 150, definitely you will not go ahead and exercise it. Okay, so you are in the money region. In the money region, in the sense, the profit region is going to be when the stock is above 150. Okay, 150 is my strike price. So I've taken an example of 180. Obviously, it is above that. That is the reason we say it is in the money. That means it is in the profit zone. When the stock price is below, okay, so call option is out of the money. When I'm saying out of the money, it essentially means that you're not in that profit zone, because the price is very low. You have an exercise price of 150. Okay, and if suppose the stock is standing at the exact strike price, suppose the stock price of ITC is 150, then we call it as at the money. To summarize, when we look at call option, okay, call option is going to be profitable when the stock price is going up. Okay, you have to remember this point. Let me give you an introduction about put option. Okay, a short summary on both long and call. Okay, now this long and call represents that if you have purchased the call option, then you will be profiting when the stock price goes up. That is the reason, do you see the line going up, right? But if suppose you have sold the option, call option, you would be making losses when the stock price goes up, right? So that's the reason we see a line coming down. So this was just a summary for long and short call. Okay, but you have to remember, when we're looking at the factors, you have to remember the call price will go up when the underlying asset will move up. Okay, let us go towards the introduction of put option. So call gave you a right to purchase something at a fixed price. The put option will give you a right to purchase, to sell something at a fixed price. Okay, let me give you an example. Suppose there is a put option available on the ITC stock. Okay, and that put option is with a strike price of 150. That means you have an option to sell the stock at fixed price of 150. Then what is the scenario that you will sell that stock? When the price of the option is below 150, say for example 80 or 90 or 70, then you have the option to sell it at a higher price. That is when you will make profit, right? But when the price of the underlying asset or ITC stock is higher, say for example at 200 or 230, that is where you will not exercise, because the current market price is very high. Why do you want to sell it at a lower price, right? So over here, you will be in profit, okay, when the price of the underlying asset is below the strike price. That means the in the money is going to be when the stock price is going down for the put option. Similarly, the loss region, or we will not make profit when the underlying asset goes up. That is out of the money region. Okay, so for this put option, you have to remember when the stock price goes down, that is where the profit region is. Okay, stock price is below the strike price. Okay, a quick summary on the long and short position for the put option. Look at the long position. When the stock price is going down, you see a red line on the screen, which is basically going up, right? The line is going up. That is where you make profit. Short position in a put option, you will lose money when the underlying asset goes down, right? That is what is for the short position. That's the reason the line is coming down. That's the reason the line is coming down. In case of any queries, kindly put it on the chat section. I'll try to address it during the session. Now let me come to the agenda, the main agenda of this session, that is the factors that impact the option price. Now there are six factors which are primarily there for the FRM curriculum. I'll be going in each factor in detail: underlying price, strike price, maturity, risk-free rate, volatility and dividend. Okay, now first we're going to be talking about the underlying asset price. Now I would need your assistance, guys. I would need your help in understanding these factors in detail. So first, think about this. If the strike price is fixed, okay, and we are talking about call option, think call option profit region was when the stock is higher. That is why if suppose we look at the first factor, which is the underlying asset price, if the underlying asset price is increasing, the call option will be in profit. Right, that means the call price should go up. Similarly, if the underlying asset is going down, that is not a profit region for call option. That means this is where the loss will happen, and that is why the call option price or the premium should go down. So for call option, there is a direct relationship between the stock price and the price of the call option moving. That means if the stock price goes up, call option price will also go up. If the stock price goes down, the call option price will also go down. Simple. Let me take you towards a put option, and then I will summarize for this first factor also. Look at the put option. We know that put option, the profit region is when a profit region is at the below side. So when the stock price goes below, that is where you will profit. That means this is where the put premium should increase. So stock price going down, the put premium is increasing. Similarly, if the stock price is going up, that is a loss region for the put option, right? So that means your put premium should go down. This is where the inverse relationship is there. Stock price is going down, the put premium is going up. Inverse relationship. And stock price going up, the put premium is coming down, right? So you can summarize it over here. There is a direct relationship between the call price and the underlying asset price, okay? And an indirect relationship or inverse relationship between the put price and the underlying asset price. I hope everybody is clear till here. Right, guys? In case of any queries, kindly put it on the chat section. So we have completed the first factor, which is important factor for your exam also. Let me come to the second factor, which is a strike price. Now look at the diagram carefully. Okay, I have kept the stock price as constant and I'm moving the strike price. Look at the stock price. I've kept it as constant. Look, let us look at the call price, call option premium. Okay, now if I take the strike price higher, that means my call will be out of the money. Why? Because call will be in the money when the stock price is above the strike price, right? So this is a scenario of out of the money. That means loss. So definitely my premium, the call premium will go down. My call premium will go down, right guys? Call premium will go down. So over here I see that the strike price going up, my call premium going down. Similarly, look at the other side. When the strike price is below and stock price is higher, okay, look at the relationship. That essentially means that you are in the money. Right? So as the strike price goes down, you are in more profit. That means the call price will increase. Right? So over here, what we saw for call option price is that there is an inverse relationship, right, between the call price and the strike price. If the strike price goes up, call price will go down. If the strike price goes down, call price will go up, right guys? So we are moving towards the second important part of this factor, which is put option. Now remember from the put option part, if the stock price is below the strike price, you are actually in the profit zone. Let us look at the scenario where I've kept the stock price in freeze and I'm trying to understand the put option. Now if the strike price is kept at a higher level, that means you're already in the money. You're already in the money. That means you are in the profit zone, right? So over here, when the strike price is going up, okay, going up, that means your put option price will also increase. Put option price will also increase. Similarly, if you look at the other side, if I take the strike price down, this is a scenario of out of the money for the put option, guys, right? So now this is a loss region. That essentially means that you are not going to benefit from this scenario. That means the option price will go down, right? So over here, we see a direct relationship between the put option price and the strike price. I've summarized it over here. There is an indirect relationship between the call price and the strike price, and direct relationship between the put price and the strike price, right? So I hope everybody is clear till here. We have completed two factors. The first two factors, the underlying asset and the strike price. I'm taking you towards the third factor, risk-free rate. Now for the risk-free rate, you have to understand, as the risk-free rate increases, okay, the stock market will also increase. That means the underlying asset price will also increase. So if the underlying asset price is increasing, whether the call will make money, whether the call will be in profit, come on guys, answer your part. If the underlying asset is going to increase, because the increase in the risk-free rate, do you feel that the call premium will increase? Right guys? Yes. Similarly, if the interest rate is increasing and the underlying asset is increasing, then the put will be in problem. Put will feel, okay, now I am in the loss region, right? Because I am in the out of the money, right? So over here, we see a direct relationship for a call option and indirect relationship for a put option. Okay? Direct relationship for a call option, indirect relationship for a put option. Perfect. So this is where the third factor, risk-free rate, is completed. I'm moving towards the next, the fourth factor, which is volatility. Now, volatility as a factor is very, very important. Okay, why? Because volatility is a friend of option trader. Okay, now think, whenever you come across this factor, think from this point. When the volatility is going to increase, that means the underlying asset is going to go up and down both, right? So it is going to get impacted in both the direction if the volatility is very high, right? Now, if the volatility is very high, there is high chance, let me talk about call option. There is high chance that it will go up. That means the call will be in the money, right? And also, if the volatility is very high, there is high chance that the stock price will go down and the put will become in the money, right? So when the volatility increases, call option and put option both benefit from it. Why? Because there is now more chance of the option being in the money. Now there is more chance that the option will be in the money. But when the volatility is very low, the stock price will not make any movement. That means wherever the stock price is, it might stay at that position itself or very close to it. That is a problem for both the option, because in that scenario, you might not be, there is very less chance that you will be in the money. For a call option, the stock price will not go up. For a put option, the stock price will not go down, right? So whenever there is a high volatility, stock price will go up and the call option will benefit. Whenever there is a high volatility, stock price will go, there is a huge chance that stock price will go down and the put option will benefit, right? So over here, in both scenarios, for call and put, whenever there is a high volatility, both of them have a direct relationship. Both of them have a direct relationship. That means whenever the volatility is increasing in the market, call option and put option price both will go up, because there is more chance that both of them will be in the money. Right? So this factor is important. You can expect some questions in the exam related to it. Now, let me take you towards the fifth option, which is dividend. Now, over here, I'm explicitly talking about cash dividend. Whenever a company issues a cash dividend, it is actually paying money out of their own pocket, their own bank balance, and giving it to the shareholders. Now, the stock price, which we see in the market, is actually a representation of all the asset and liability of the company. If the asset is going down, if the asset is getting reduced because you're making payment to the shareholder, then definitely your stock price should come down. That is why when we see that the companies are issuing dividend, their stock price will also reduce by the amount of the dividend. Now think from the option perspective. What is going to happen? Think, and I would need your answer. If the company is going to give a very high dividend, then stock price will go down. Who will benefit? Call or put? Who will benefit? Come on, guys. Call or put? I would need your answer, guys. Who is going to benefit? Right, it's put option. Who is going to benefit, right? Because put option has a profit region at the bottom, right? So if the stock is going to give a heavy dividend, then call option price will go down, right? And the put option price will go up, right? So if there is a high dividend, call will face a problem, put will make money. If there is a small dividend, okay, then again the call will lose, but it will not lose much value, okay? So over here, the call option is getting very much impacted, in the sense the price will go down if the dividend is very huge, okay? And the put option is going to get benefited, because as big dividend as I get, my put premium will increase, right? So this was the fifth factor which was there for your option pricing methodology. Let me take you towards the final factor, which is maturity, okay, or the time. Now, I hope you guys remember, okay, from the previous topic, there is one more topic before this chapter, which is properties, options market. Now, over there, we had already read about option price comprising of two things. Option price is made out of two things. What are those two things, guys? Anybody remember? Kindly put it in the chat section. Option price is made out of two things. Come on, guys. It is the intrinsic value and the time value, right? What is intrinsic value? Intrinsic value is how much in the money you are. How much in the money you are, right? Option price. I was talking about option price. What two things are making the option price? I hope everybody is now clear. Intrinsic value and time value. What is intrinsic value? Suppose if I look at a call option, if the strike price is 100 and the stock price is 150, that means the intrinsic value is 50. How much in the money you are? Okay, but what is time value? Time value is basically a charge which is there in the option price. Okay, to take into account, if suppose there is huge time left, that means if the maturity of the contract is very high, that means you have more time to be in the money, right? If the maturity is very low, that means you have very less time of being in the money. That is being covered in time value. So think from the perspective, if the maturity is increasing, that means the time value component will increase. That means the option price will increase. If the maturity is going to go down, then the time value component will go down and then the option price will go down. Right? Right? So in a very simple language, there is a direct relationship for both the call and the put. Because if the maturity is very high, both call and put option will have more time of being in the money. And for both of them, the time value component will be very high. So both of them are going to benefit. And there is a direct relationship between them. But there is a small caveat that we should remember about the maturity piece. What is that? Okay. Now, when we talk about maturity, we cannot make this blanket statement that when the maturity is very high, the premium has to be high. We can look at one particular scenario regarding European call option. Let me tell you that there is one European call option that you have is for 3 months time. I hope you can see the timeline. And there is one more European option which is available for 4 months. And I'm giving you explicit information that between that 3 and 4 months, we expect a huge dividend to come. Now think logically, whenever the dividend is going to come, the price of the stock will go down. When the price will go down, the call option price will also go down. Right? So somebody who is holding a 4 month option, who will get impacted because of the dividend, the price of the call option of a 4 month option will be less as compared to the 3 month call option. Right? I hope everybody is clear. The small deviation that we see for the European call option. Give me a quick confirmation, guys. We have completed all the 6 factors and now I'm going to summarize. In case of any queries, kindly put it on the chat section, guys. Let me take you to the summary piece. Now, in the summary, the first part, the stock price, we saw that there is a direct relationship between the call option, okay, but indirect for the put option. For the strike price, we saw the direct relationship for the indirect relationship for the call option and direct relationship for the put option, right? Now, but when we look at the time part, the latest part, I have explicitly added question mark over here. We cannot make a blanket statement. Why? Because for European options, there can be an impact because of the dividend piece, right? There can be an impact because of the dividend piece. So this is where we did a summarization of the entire thing. Okay. All the 6 factors are important for the exam. Now we'll quickly go towards the questions. Few of the questions which can help you to, we can see if you have understood the concept or not. Let me take you towards the first question. Come on, guys. I would need your answers. Start posting your answers on the chat section as 1.A, 1.B, 1.C or 1.D. Come on, guys. Okay, so we'll start with a solution. Okay, which of the variable given below is likely to have a smallest impact on the price of the plain vanilla stock option? We know the factors, okay? The strike price of the option, okay? Expected dividend, risk-free rate. These were the factors which were impacting the option. But this part we never read about. But one more small point that you should note. When we're talking about plain vanilla stock option, these options will either be traded on the exchange or in the OTC market, there will be a clearing house because it's a standard document. So when there is a CCP or a clearing house, the credit worthiness of the counterparty is not a problem for you. Right? And also, this is not one of the factors which impacts. Right? So answer is D. That is what all of you guys were saying. Okay? Let me take you towards the second question. Read the options properly and start posting your answers. Come on, guys, what is the answer for the second question? Okay, I'll start with the question now. So they have given you a lot of unnecessary information. Okay, if you read the first 5-6 line, they're talking about some concerned person. Rajkumar is working, he's taking some position, he has purchased a call option, he has purchased a put option, whatever. Then there's one line which is important. If the stock price decreases, then which of the following shows the accurate effect? So, and he has taken a call and a put option, right? When the stock price goes down, the call price will also goes down and the put price will increase. Where do we see this? Can we see it in the option B? Right? You have to remember that factor. When the underlying asset goes down, call price will go down and put price will go up. That's the reason we have the B option. Now, this kind of question that you see in the exam, it would be necessary for you to read all the options. It is going to be time consuming. And also in the question, they will give you a lot of unnecessary information which might not be directly relevant to the question. Okay? Let me take you towards the third question. Come on, guys. Start solving. So, what is the answer for the third question? Okay, I'll start with the solution now. Third question. They have given you a lot of unnecessary information. Okay, the starting part, there is a fund that they are managing. $800 million is the fund size. The Signet portfolio consists of call and put and all of that. The important line over here, due to the upcoming elections in the US, the volatility of these indexes on which you have taken options is also going to increase. So what is going to be the impact on the option price? Whenever there is a volatility increase, what happens? Call price will also go up and put price will also go up. That is available in your last option, which is option D. Both will increase. Right, guys? So you have to remember the factor in such a way, the questions will come in such manner. All good? So this is where we have kind of completed the section for today's session. Now, a quick introduction about our institute. We basically train for CFA and FRM, and we are currently training online also. There's an online lectures that we conduct. For FRM, we do conduct for around 120 to 150 hours of session. There'll be a quick question bank on chapter-wise questions, sectional tests, important concept quizzes, and also mock papers available for all of you to prepare. There'll be a recorded session backup also for the live online session. Further, We also provide video lectures for students who cannot prepare, cannot come on weekends for the sessions, for the live sessions. Then they can take our video lecture and prepare for the exam. And we also provide test series for students who are already reading on their own. They want to enhance their preparation. So we provide them with our notes, with our question bank and all of it. Okay. So that is available for us. We also help new students who are going to go for the November exam. They can get some free material and free Excel sheet. We are going to be rolling out those details in few days through our channel. And that is where you guys can get the Excel sheet on how to prepare for the exam, on how to keep on doing the flow of preparation, and also some important material for your exam. Okay. So any queries, guys, right now, I'll be there for the next few minutes. Any queries specific to the content that we have completed? Perfect. If there is no queries, then we will close today's session. Okay, in case there is still any queries, you can reach out to us on our WhatsApp number and we'll try to address it as soon as possible. Okay, so thank you very much, guys, for joining today's session. Tomorrow also, we are going to be having a session on the optimal hedge ratio. Okay, thank you very much, guys.